Good day just for you, crew, and welcome to the Southampton, England vlog. Just for you. Rough night last night. Matt just wanted to keep buying me beers. I'm like, no. I need to function. So I managed to hold him off a little bit, but not enough. Because, like, everything was fine. Got to the room, and then that's when it really started kicking in. I turned the TV on just to hang back for a minute, and I was maybe it wasn't the alcohol, because I just like passed right out. I was watching Blade, and next thing I know, like, something happened in the movie, I guess, that was loud, and that woke me up, and I was just like, how did I even fall asleep? I don't even remember, like, falling asleep. It was just like, done, passed out, gone. But again, I don't think it was the alcohol. I only had I had 1, 2, 3 drinks up till dinner, and then when we came over here, and I only had maybe 3 more drinks, and so 6 pints shouldn't have done me in like that. So it must have been the traveling and then the alcohol, bad combination. Anyway, so right now I'm compressing all the footage from yesterday's stuff. And I try and get that out to you as much as, or as fast as possible. Probably I'm going to have to break these things down into 2 pieces, 2 parts, so that they're not crazy long. I'm not sure how long this is, but I already know I had to break up the last one. So right now it is 9:32 in the morning. I got up at 9. I'm going to have to zip out, do possibly the English breakfast thing first, and because it's Friday, I got to get a video out to you guys, so it's getting tight. All right, people, I'm about halfway finished editing the vlog, the other half of yesterday's vlog. I've just finished showering. The water comes out really fast, and about halfway through the shower, then it got really hot, so like I actually had it cranked super hot to start with. And it came out nice and warm, which was like my level of heat. Then halfway through the shower, it started going hotter and hotter, and you had to like quickly back it off. This is my view. So the window's way up here. I can't see what you guys are seeing at the moment, but every once in a while, pigeons or something lands there. It's probably a pigeon. And I heard some seagulls this morning. So the boys are down at the pub waiting for me. So I'm kind of hoping that we could I guess I'm ready to clean the rooms. I got my key. Good. So the boys are waiting for me. Hopefully I can get a food video in as soon as possible. And it'll be like uncut and raw, because that's just the way it's gonna have to be if I'm gonna get a video done and out. Hardly any editing. Keep turning the doorknobs. Anyway, so we'll see you down at the pub. This is what it's like in the daytime. Still wet. Guys, we just finished our breakfast. We also did a food review just for you, and but we're out of here. One thing I didn't rate that you guys get to hear about is their coffee. It is crazy strong compared to
wake you up in the morning.
It definitely woke me up. If I had any slight hangover, it's gone.
Boom, like that.
Oh, just boom. Yep. But again, walking through there and just watching all the people in there drinking alcohol at like 10 o'clock in the morning, it was pretty funny.
That's a normality.
Yeah, you can't, I think a bar in Ontario at least can't open up until 11.
Really? So they changed the laws in this country.
Yeah,
recently? It used to be like you can't buy alcohol after like 11 p.m. in shops and stuff like that, and pubs can only open at certain times. Now it's like, buy whenever you want.
Right. So, yeah, I think a lot of rules and stuff.
I think like clubs have to go like 4.
Back a long time ago, rules and stuff were set by churches. That's why, you know, stores weren't open on Sunday. But especially in Canada,
so many different cultures, and some of them aren't religious, right? So, their rights are like, well, why can't I have my store open on a Sunday, right? So,
I hate the fact that our shops are open 10 till 4, because if you work a 9 to 5 and you've only got a weekend, and you've got getting done by 4 o'clock on a Sunday,
right? Yeah,
I hate the fact that store exists.
But isn't it up to the store owner to be open whenever they want to?
It's the law, you have to be closed by 4.
Why?
In this country,
that's not a law. That's stupidity.
And it's all done on religious purposes, because the churches and stuff.
Exactly. That religion shouldn't be part of it.
No, it should be wanting to make money, right?
If you want to show, did you guys ever? You guys didn't eat at Chick-fil-A when you were in the States, did you? Because the owners of the company are very religious, and all their restaurants shut down on Sunday.
Wow.
Whether the people that own that restaurant or not are religious, they cannot be open on Sunday.
Yeah.
So explain the significance of this castle.
Lewis, go.
I couldn't tell you, mate. I couldn't tell you either. I'm so sorry, everyone watching.
I'm terrible
expecting history. An insightful.
I did this in history lesson. Sorry.
I did GCSE history. I did history for 5 years, and I say
it's very cool. It's probably not relevant to like war or anything.
Oh no,
the other side is nicer.
This is way older than.
Yeah, but it'd be interesting to know if it was built as a castle to be a castle, or was it?
Do you want to see something even older than this castle? Bargain shopping
cart. Oh, yeah. Oh, nice.
Look at that.
Bargain.
Broken, horrible mess.
Oh, Burger King. Oh, it's shut down.
I'm trying to sell my city here, but that's set on fire quite recently.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They really cook their burgers good.
They're really grilled.
So this part of the wall is broken, but actually continues on way down there. So it was a big castle. Ah. Do you want to read it for me?
In the 12th century, this northern gateway to the medieval towns was medieval. Was a single round archway. In the 13th century, two round towers were added early. So that would be that one and this one. In the 15th century, the north front was extended. The Guildhall now has a museum, formerly the town's administrative centre, and used for public functions. So, it's 12th century.
And the Guildhall's obviously never in the town, but we'll take you there.
And
point.
In the 13th century, the two round towers were added, so I'm guessing...
I would have read it, but I'm Canadian, and that's English, so...
I'm guessing everyone can just pause it.
They've
ruined it all this, unfortunately. You can only walk through it.
Yeah,
you normally because of all this Christmas stuff.
Oh, only because it's Christmas.
You normally just walk through there.
Did the wall continue that way too?
Yeah.
And then
because if you go through that thing, you can see the continuation of the walls.
So I wonder what wrecked it. Like why they, and what was there an actual boundary all the way around then?
Yeah, I think it was. I think it was all connected together.
Do you think it went?
You can still keep going. Does the walls keep going that way? That's where they do.
Do you think
you can do a Savannah walls tour? You can do like a walls tour.
Oh, okay.
Tour.
I think I did it.
Like
when
walk
I was
on. Like that one, you can actually kind of walk on. If that makes sense. Like there's stairs behind
you.
Yeah,
go up.
Okay.
There.
Oh, there's people up there.
Yeah.
Let's go. All right, we're on top of the wall. What are you saying about the mall?
So that's our main shopping centre in Southampton, West Quay.
West Quay.
And all this over here, all the building, they're currently extending it to make West Quay Plaza. We're going to have endless amount of new restaurants, cinemas.
I said, when I came in, I knew that's key, but I said, West Quay.
Quay. If no one told me it was said key, I would have pronounced it Quay.
Yeah. Inside, they decided some of the things they're making. So they're making Nando's.
Oh, right,
guys,
right.
All that kind of stuff, so.
And so there's going to be another Five Guys, or there already is one?
I haven't got one in Southampton yet.
Five Guys has really kicked off at the moment, like in the same way that Nando's did.
John Fleming, he was frozen on the first nuclear explosion that happened here. Is frozen in that position.
Stop giving people false information. I didn't even know.
And I'm pretty sure he was stuck in this pose because he was just about to piss off his wall.
He was spitting over the edge of
people. He was spitting,
on the bus.
The peasants.
You peasants.
He was spitting on the peasants. So there's another continuation of the wall. So the castle did go this way, south. So I wonder what was inside the walls. Was it a town or a military facility?
I wish there were better tour guides.
I'm just going completely on guessing here. I would assume that the town had a wall around it, and then the village in the main town was inside.
Yeah, because this is like medieval old, right?
Yeah, if you think medieval, like all the cities had big old walls around them. I could just be making this entirely up.
Yeah, well, I agree with you.
Going on, I'm just assuming. Yeah, I reckon the town would have been in the middle, surrounded by the big wall.
Yeah, and then everybody in the town has to protect it, yeah. So... That was the whole logic of building a castle and a town in front of it.
Yeah, I can't see why they built a castle, like, for not protected. Like, just for looks.
The problem we've got with this, right, this bit's really nice, it's cool coming here, but you have no view now. But that way, you can see all the cruise ships that came into it, like you left Southampton and stuff like that. But now it's just, because that's in the way, this way you've just got terrible pound blocked land. Houses, a pound land.
Good old look at Poundland.
So you can see the wall that goes through, and they just smashed it down to build
a road.
A road. I wonder if it was smashed down, or they just said, you know what, we need to put a road through here.
I assume they probably, beat it down.
I wonder how many things inside this wall are still, like, none of those buildings for sure look like it, but the wall continues that way.
Oh, here we are. 1400.
There you go, guys. Some more data for you.
I'm not reading through that again.
No.
The keeper of Southampton. I want to be the keeper of Southampton, but not the goalkeeper.
How would you pronounce that guy's name?
And the keeper
Arundel.
Of Southampton.
Arundel.
Arundel.
So this was a military facility, I would imagine. Yeah. So you can see the wall continue down there, guys.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So it goes all the way down, and then it probably curves
that,
around.
Yeah. Is that that there?
Yes.
That's there, yeah.
Yeah.
So we're like here.
We're way back, yeah.
Oh, yeah, over here.
We should really explore my city one day.
Yeah, I think I came up here once on a primary school visit when I must have been about like 6 or 7. I've never been up here since.
Oh my god, look! A battery!
Oh, the 1800s!
Nice!
Is that
the
same
So there's the tower there, comes back, even more wall. It's amazing how old this rock is that they built to keep out the bad guys. Okay, we just slipped into the mall here, and let's check out these shirts. Oh my goodness, that is awesome.
That's amazing. Ken, you're a hero.
We are in Lewis's car.
Yeah,
It's called the Milf Hunter.
It's the Porsche.
His name's John.
911, I'm not crushed in the back here.
Sorry. I'm really sorry about that.
It's a recycled Ferrari. It's cheaper to buy a recycled one.
They just squashed it together.
So how much did it cost for parking?
£2.50.
£2.50.
We've been there about 2.5 hours.
Yeah, that's expensive.
It is very expensive. But
and is it all about time or is it per day?
Time.
Or?
Okay. The longer you stay, the cheaper it is.
Right.
So if you stay for like 10 minutes, it'll cost you £1. But if you stay for 15 hours, it'll cost you like 10. Doesn't make sense.
£10.
Yep.
Oh, quid, right.
£10.
Yeah.
£10.
Pound, son.
Right, so pounds.
Down again. Where are you going? Reverse.
Oh, I know.
Down again.
I swear we never went this fucking high up. I swear we only went like 2 floors
down
up.
Down again.
I saw the queue over there.
It's like being with an old married couple here.
I thought we were on the bottom floor.
Down here!
To the left.
I've started thinking recently. I might go.
To the right, to the right.
To the left.
I keep just missing really obvious things.
In this my story car park, we drive on the wrong side of the road.
We
drive on the right.
Yeah,
we don't drive on the left.
The only time I've ever driven on the left, on the right side steering wheel hand thingy, is in Barbados, and I handled it pretty well. But you really had to concentrate.
Did you drive automatic?
Fucking way, love.
In Canada, do you drive automatic?
No, I drive stick. So it'd be really weird driving stick.
He's 3 miles away from it, look. Can he reach it? Can he reach it?
Yeah,
this is gonna be epic. This is where you get your arm cut off and I got on video.
Go on, you can get it in there.
Floor it.
Right, to the bridge, yeah? To the bridge.
To the bridge.
Run that woman over.
Are you kidding? He likes me a little more now. So I'm wearing the Southampton football team.
Proper football team. The real football.
The one you
usually eat with. Why are you pinching my nipple?
Just getting the tag out of your way.
I was holding
the badge, like, yeah, baby.
So right now we're discussing why we can't find Lewis's ass.
Why are you
will fucking leave me alone.
As he holds a child.
Not sure why it's...
Yeah, I'm holding a baby, so if you touch me up, I will.
I will use it as a weapon.
Yeah. I'll beat you with it.
I'll beat you with
this
child.
I was going to go along the lines of it would be wrong, but no, it's...
Yeah,
I'll
you
use
know
the baby
it.
So now we're just discussing what challenge we're going to do on their channel.
So it was in the message. Dudesons, where's my challenge? Whatever.
Because you wouldn't, yeah, you do it to them for
it's you.
Do you want to do a video with me?
Check it out!
Wrap around your mouth.
Except that one.
4-4.
Hello.
You're gay.
I don't know what to say. You think you're all that, but you're not.
Animal boom!
Animal boom!
My name is John. I'm the...
So confused, everybody have different names.
I'm the medical technician here at wherever we are.
It's
Fulton Towers.
Flanders Enterprises, whatever.
Huge tip, always try to look at the lens.
Oh.
But go through your peripherals, look at the screen.
Okay. I kept doing that. I was like, I was trying to figure out...
So I turned it around when I started reading.
Yeah, I couldn't figure... It took me like a minute to see even... Steven.
So I'll come back for a second. Hello, my name is Stephen. I was John or something a minute ago, but I changed my name by Deepole just 5 seconds ago. This is Rupert. Say hello.
Rupert.
I know nothing. I know nothing about the dragonfly.
Also, we have...
Oklahoma! Rupert. Why does he have a cork on his fork?
Cork
on his fork.
I mentioned you.
You did.
I did, indeed.
I should, like...
Guys, habit to look at myself. I'm looking at the thing, not the lens. Over here we have, what's your name, sir?
What's the van?
Bob.
Bob? We know Bob. Some high-tech IT work.
Hating life. That's what I'm doing. Don't know about you.
Señor?
Don't know what to say.
I just hope someday they can afford to get a desk.
For
this area.
It'd be so nice if I could work on a desk.
What did I say? Go.
Do.
Go work on my desk.
They won't let me sit over there.
No.
I'm not qualified.
We don't like foreigners here. They've got to sit on the floor.
I don't know what to say.
I don't know what to say.
This is how I feel right now.
Can I get my Santa costume?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have a PlayStation. And an Xbox. And a Matthew. Sorry, what's your name? I'm Stephen. And there's Rupert and Bob.
Brent.
So our new employee Brent is here. Say hello, Brent.
Yo.
What are you doing, Brent? Some
what's
important work?
Nah, I was.
Looking at pornography, Brent.
Yeah. Get Brent. Bitch.
Get Brent. Oh, that's Brent. He's a funny old chap. Oh, what? Oh, what?
Brent is a place and we went into that render hall and just shot.
He came up with the idea of having all those little elements.
We saw, hello.
We sort of shot things.
Mate, my nose is so big then.
Last.
All right, guys, we're about to shoot. What's it called? This
Secret Santa.
The Secret Santa picking thing.
The beginning.
The beginning of it. So they're going to
draw names out.
Draw names, and then what you guys buy,
and
you're going to have to.
We're going to buy presents for each other, obviously not knowing who we're going to buy for. And then in a week's time, we're going to open our presents.
And it'll be all on video. Of course, that's what YouTubers do. And obviously, you're present.
Hmm.
Are you Christmas present or a pass?
Right.
You are an elf.
I'm future. I'm Christmas future.
I'm Jesus, get it right.
This is the hard one to figure out. It took me a while. Turkey!
More like a testicle.
It's a chef hat.
He's a big testicle.
Right. Nice. I can't really. The nice. You guys actually want like real Christmas presents.
Cool.
You?
No. Where's my challenge?
Rules, you're not allowed to do that.
Can't spin.
What the?
You spin, you lose.
Is this game plan ruined already?
Yeah, my game plan. I was going to tickle chocolate.
Are you ready?
Okay, go!
Ken.
Here we go.
KBDProductionsTV.
Right.
Let's go. It's going to go straight in.
Go on, Ken.
Go on, Ken.
How weird would it be if Ken beat Matt and let his first go?
That could happen.
He's still undefeated.
I like his little rocking technique where he rocks backwards and forwards. It's really good. Yes.
Go! Boom! Ruin.
As I said, only one goal.
It's that football shirt. It's that great football shirt.
It's the football shirt.
Making him better at football. Great team. Bet you feel stupid right now.
Have I got bloodshot eyes?
Not really, no.
I don't even smoke.
Okay, best out of three.
Right, this is match point. Come on, Ken.
That's Ken's point.
Matt has not lost a singles game. You can do it.
Come on, Kenneth, I believe.
My guys are lacking.
Debut.
Shit!
This feels like the other table ever again. Yeah. I'm emotional.
So the reason we're super excited is because he is undefeated.
Undefeated, never lost.
It's the poutine.
What, chips and gravy? Chips and gravy.
Just finished shooting Jerry's mustard gas challenge and. Yeah, you'll have to wait until it comes out on their channel, but check it out.
Hopefully Monday.
Oh, really? That soon?
Yeah, because people can play it, like, is this going out?
This will go out tomorrow.
Oh, okay, so if you are a fan of Where's My Challenge, a lot of people complain about vomit videos, there'll definitely be one Monday.
See his eyes?
So stop crying.
That's how you can tell, right there.
Mate.
You'll love it.
Oh my God, I've got a fuzzy tummy.
Yeah, my stomach's like just achy right now.
Good.
I only did three tablespoons, well, 2.5.
Okay, well, I'm going to head off in a minute then.
Yeah.
I'll get a lift about half an
hour. Well, I'll have to head off soon.
Hey. So I just come in for you?
Yeah.
Can I come with you?
And Matt's a little hungover right now.
Well, I'll go back to mine though, briefly.
I don't think I'm hungover, that's the thing.
Oh.
Because,
all right, we're finished up here at the headquarters of Where's My Challenge?
But where is your challenge?
That's right. And we're heading off to the Hobbit. This is a pub. And hopefully people will show up. If they don't, we'll just drink. Except maybe Matt won't drink.
Oh, you know I'm drinking.
I've never heard that before.
Before, why are we here?
He wants to see if there's blood pudding and stuff.
Oh, right, we're looking for the blood pudding.
I need to get baby stuff, so.
Oh, right.
I don't know if he's going to say this on camera.
Oh. Okay. No, as soon as I hear that and I see the guys dressed like that, it's Mr. Bean.
Yes.
The Mr. Bean Christmas special.
So you're at Tesco. One of the leading supermarkets in England.
It's the traditional dance in this song.
Oh boy.
I need to get some Barbie food.
So this is like a regular food market plus clothing and toys.
Your Walmart and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So
they don't have groceries.
Target.
Yeah, Target's gone out of Canada.
All right.
They didn't make it.
Oh, really?
Over there.
So I just got the Jaffa cakes, stick. So it's huge. Yeah, I got some other goodies inside my bag. I'll just show you quickly while we're waiting. So one of you guys wanted me to do the Iron Maiden brew. I got that. And then we got two bottles of this.
He's doing his
vlogging. I'm doing my vlogging. Gotta go.
It's a very, very
long day. It's 25 to 10. We're a bit late.
We were meant to go to the Hobbit at 9.
We're running late. Because Paul drives like an old lady, and it took us forever.
You know what? No, fuck you and your Canadian ways.
So we're off to the Hobbit to do a meetup, have a few beers. That guy needs to
check his power steering levels, because that was crazy loud. All right, guys, this is the Hobbit. First time ever seeing this place. But that's the first time I've ever been here. Nice, the Hobbit. Very cool. One of the cool things about this place is the cocktails are named after people or characters from The Hobbit. Which is the best one?
I've had the Gandalf before, it was pretty good.
Okay, I'll do a Gandalf first. Okay guys, we are on one of the levels outside The Hobbit and we came up here. This is near the Black Tower. No, it's not. But a couple of awesome people came out, Ash and Bex.
And me.
Oh, and there's Harry.
I can see you, Ken. I love your
channel. Aww.
I watched it once.
I watched it once, and then I deleted it.
Will you sign my balls, Ken?
I'll sign my balls.
Sign my octopus head.
You don't want to see his Optimus head. You probably already have seen it.
Yeah, dude.
And right now, I am drinking a Gandalf. Have you tried any of the weird drinks here? Or?
I haven't. No.
What did you have earlier?
I'm just drinking Coke. I'm driving.
But there was a bottle on here. What was it?
That's yours. That's J2O.
Oh, what is that?
It's a fruity, juicy.
And it's sort of like half ice soft drinks.
Oh, okay. So it's apple and mango.
Yeah.
Let me know if you've tried that, guys. Tell me if Vax has good taste buds or not.
No, we got told by Ash's best mate to try, what was it?
A golem.
Vodka, orange, and lemonade. Apparently, that's really, really good.
So the golem's supposed to be good?
Yeah.
I'll try that next.
It's supposed to be good.
And they're like $4.90? So some of them are more expensive than others,
yeah.
Right?
I think it's depending on what's in them. Yeah.
Okay.
And how many shots you got and stuff like
that's
that
right.
As well.
Because you can add stuff to it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You can double that up?
Yeah.
But of course they charge you for that. So when I bought my jersey today, as these people already know, they're like, she's like, oh, because we grabbed the jersey off the shelf that had, it looked like an armband on it already, or a badge or whatever.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh no, that's just a sticker. If you want the actual badge on it, it's £6 more. I'm like, how much does it cost to stand here? And she wasn't amused.
My mother was an alcoholic.
Got a bit of a smoke.
I was.
All right, guys, big cheers.
It's like
at the Gollum, at the Hobbit, the Gollum. Because I'm drinking a Gollum.
It's like
a Gollum.
Oh.
The smoke is good, though. It's like dry ice.
I'm having my amazing alcoholic drink, which is actually just
a Coca-Cola. The finest alcoholic
drink. Finest Coca-Cola, because I'm a bloody...
Me and Ken are drunk. Ken's drunk as well.
Almost. Okay guys, the boys just dropped me off here. I forgot to do like a quick little goodbye video, but we'll see them again tomorrow all day. It's gonna be absolutely fantastic. Oh, they got my bag. Damn it. Young 49-year-old. All right guys, just as I went to phone Pauly back, this gentleman right here. What's your name?
Domik.
Domik?
Yeah.
My last name's Domik.
Really?
D-O-M-I-K.
Oh no, D-O-M-I-N-I-C.
I know,
no,
Domik.
Yeah.
People call me Domik, but they don't know. Anyway, nice to meet you, sir.
Young man, take it easy.
See ya. All right, so, obviously they had a party here tonight. And, but, I think Harry realized that my bag was in the back of the car. So they actually came back. As I was phoning him, I looked around and I saw Matt coming across the road with my stuff. So I'm so happy that I got my stuff so I can edit for you. I forgot it's 1 o'clock in the morning. We gotta be quiet. Shh. Okay guys, it's time for bed. I'm pretty tired. It's 1 o'clock in the morning here. That would be 8 o'clock at night in Toronto, Canada. So
I'm tired, though. It's time for beddy bed beds. I'm glad they got my bag back so I can do some editing for you guys, get the vlog out. I'll probably just upload it tomorrow morning from Where's My Challenge headquarters, because they have really good internet speed, just a bit faster than mine at home. So there was like 11.88, whereas mine sometimes fluctuates between 10 and 12. So thanks, Where's My Challenge. Good night. And now it's time for happy birthday shoutouts for Saturday, December 12th, all the way from Southampton, England, to you. And it is Harry, Jason, and Fred. Happy birthday to each and every single one of you. Don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section below as to what you have for your special birthday dinner, whether you ate in or ate out. Don't forget to take a picture. Happy birthday.